Hi. I think the time has come that I need to break up with one of my networking groups. You see, about a month ago, I have decided to put my direct sales career on the back burner and pursue a position that fits with my brand much better than direct selling does. I am the blogging coach for the Social Networking Coaching Club, and I have been for about 3 weeks now. And the reaction I get from one of the networking groups I regularly attend has been quite amazing to me. Because when I stand up and give my 3-minute spiel on what I do as a blogging coach and what the Social Networking Coaching Club is all about, it is met with indifference, disinterest, and almost disappointment on the part of the networking members that I'm no longer part of the direct sales tribe. Now, direct salespeople often ask for home parties because that is the best way to make money. One of the reasons I decided to back off from direct sales is because I'm not good at asking for parties, and the money I was making doing parties wasn't really worth all of the time that I was putting into preparing to get to the parties. An opportunity came along that perfectly aligns with my main job, which is a tutor broker. I match qualified teachers, tutors, and educators with students in need of in-home tutoring. And I have a national business which teaches people how to do what I do. I frequently blog about it. And back in October, I joined the Social Networking Coaching Club as a student, went through the entire program, and I am now the blogging coach for that portion of the Social Networking Coaching Club, which has helped my tutoring businesses tremendously. And I find that I no longer have time for my direct sales, and that it was not meant to be anymore, that is what I pursue for a living. So my networking group is quite interesting now because when I am speaking, people are not listening or looking at me. After the meeting, when we have plenty of time to mingle and speak with each other and exchange referrals or leads or just find out more about what the other person's doing, no one approaches me. That's kind of a good sign to me that either they can't relate to what I'm doing, they're not interested in what I'm doing, they don't get what I'm doing, or they're looking at me as a commodity that, since I'm no longer in direct sales, they don't think I'm going to support them in their direct sales efforts, which is totally untrue because I'm always up for a good party. And if somebody is selling something that I need or want, I will support my networking sisters by going. But I'm not getting that feeling from this one meeting that I attend, so I'm going to break up with them. So I'm asking, have you ever changed careers or reinvented yourself or added or taken away from your responsibilities a different job or a different career path that you choose to go down? And have you ever met with resistance, indifference, people turn their backs or they just don't want to refer you and they kind of kick you out of their little group? Because that's kind of what's happened to me. And I'm taking it all in stride because I also am the leader of a local networking group where I get to pick and choose the people that come. And I believe that's going to be way more beneficial for me than continuing to attend a meeting where people just don't seem to be able to engage and give me an opportunity to tell them and share with them what I do. I don't sell people. I'm not a slimy salesperson. That's not how I've ever been, and that's certainly not how I was taught to be. One of the big things about going through the Social Networking Coaching Club is that it's all about education-based marketing, not slimy salespeople. So my breakup is almost finished. I believe today was the last time that I am going to be attending that meeting. I wish all of those people good luck. And I am really looking forward to pursuing some new networking opportunities as a blogging coach and getting way more involved in social networking because that's where it's at right now. It's not the future, it's now. And I feel kind of sorry for the people that I'm leaving behind, but I look at it as it's their loss. Thanks for listening.